Mary Lincoln? She was crazy. Elizabeth Keckley? Who? The Mary and Elizabeth Museum Gift Shop displays facsimile Lincoln memorabilia in a tribute to Mary Lincoln and her dressmaker, Elizabeth Keckley. This diorama by artist Susan Bercu intends to release Mary from false perceptions that she was crazy and a thief, and to rescue Elizabeth from anonymity. Both women suffered for their offenses of superior intelligence and independent spirit at a time when slaves were forbidden to read and write, and even white women were expected to keep their place. The outspoken, politically astute Mary Lincoln rankled powerful men, especially the president's enemies. Elizabeth Keckley established a successful dressmaking business in the capital city when, after years as a slave, she purchased freedom for herself and her only son, George. When secession loomed, her most notable clients, Mrs. Robert E. Lee and Mrs. Jefferson Davis, went south. Elizabeth sought out the first lady who required gowns for hundreds of state-related events. The two women developed a deep friendship that crossed the color line, a rarity in the Civil War era. Both George and the Lincoln son Robert were Union soldiers. Elizabeth likely made George a sewing kit called a housewife that was a common addition to soldiers' gear. When Elizabeth founded the Contraband Relief Association to help former slaves become autonomous, Mary lent a hand, donated, and raised funds. Born into a slave-owning family in Lexington, Kentucky, she could trace her abolitionism to when she'd seen chained human beings pass by her front door to the auction block. While the Lincolns lived in Springfield, one of their four sons, Eddie, died. When 11-year-old Willie succumbed to illness during the second inaugural ball, Elizabeth consoled Mary, and again when the president was assassinated. Without a government widow's pension or will to provide for her, Mary was desperate for funds. Elizabeth sacrificed her business to help Mary sell articles from her wardrobe. Nothing sold, and the press skewered the black-veiled widow in the old clothes scandal. To produce an income and salvage Mary's reputation, Elizabeth wrote Behind the Scenes, a memoir of her life and her time with the Lincolns. Not only did the press insist that a slave couldn't write a book, the publisher didn't pay her and reneged on a promise by printing private correspondence of the Lincolns. Mary was so angry that her intimate life was exposed, she refused contact with Elizabeth, including her gift of the quilt she stitched from Mary's dress scraps. After multiple tragedies, her son Tad's death in 1871 propelled Mary into a depression so deep that Robert unduly used his political clout to commit her to a mental hospital. Although she was lucid enough to secure a legal team to obtain her release and have her declared sane, history has not absolved her of the crazy label. Biographers still repeat the inaccurate, venomous accounts about her by Abraham Lincoln's law partner and biographer William H. Herndon. Mary continues to be falsely accused of accumulating massive debt on furnishings for the sorely neglected executive mansion. Yet, government records prove that Commissioner William S. Wood stole money from the accounts and blamed Mary for the shortfalls. In fact, she was extremely frugal, as ordering fabrics and gloves in bulk for huge discounts. Mary died on July 16, 1882 in Springfield, where she joined her husband and three sons in the Lincoln tomb. Elizabeth was destitute when she died in May of 1907.